And welcome to Lecture Loops. Today's topic is looping. So basically in today's video we are going to cover the topics: what is looping, then what are entry control and exit control loops, then for loop, while loop and do while. Okay, and also we will discuss what is nested looping. So let's start the video, but before that, first go and subscribe to my channel, okay, if you want to have more videos like this. Okay, so let's begin. So first of all, we'll see basically what is looping. Sometimes in programming we need to repeat some similar tasks. Okay, so for repeating these similar tasks we need not to write same statement again and again. Okay, suppose you want to print like cout hello. Now if you print this statement, hello statement, 10 times or 50 times or 100 times, then it is not logical or sensible to write this print statement 10 times or 50 times. Okay, repeating same and same task again and again. Okay, so for that, you know, looping statements are there. It is present in each and every programming language. So with the help of looping we can repeat same task or similar task again and again. Okay, so how we do this? So basically there are four components in any looping statement in any programming language. Okay, so first is initialization. So from where we have to start? Okay, suppose we want to print this hello 10 times, then we should start from 1, we should stop at 10. Okay, so the initialization is 1. Okay, start from 1. This is the initialization. The next is terminating condition, means when to stop. This is very important. In absence of terminating condition, our loop is going to, for infinite times, it is going to repeat the task. Okay. So beware of this, infinite loop. So this is terminating condition, means suppose we want to print hello 10 times, then initialization start from 1, stop at 10. Okay, and then updation is very important. Updation means 1, then 2, and then 3, then 4. So this is updation, you have to update. Okay, so you will take some counter variable, okay, like t, and you will initialize t by 1. Okay, then you will terminate t when you will terminate when t becomes 10, and updation you will increment t 1 by 1. Okay, so t will be 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, like this. Okay, then there is body of the loop. Body of the loop contains the statements that we want to repeat or iterate. Okay, so this is all about the components of this loop. Then there are basically three types of loops in C++. Number one is while loop. Number two is do while loop. Number three is for loop. Okay, and we are going to study them in the same sequence. Okay, for loop is very popular, but while loop, I will say it is a simple. Okay, it is simplest of all the loops. Okay, so first of all, we are going to see that how while loop works. Then gradually we will see about do while loop and for loop and also about nested loop. Okay, in the same video. So be there, be throughout the video. And so first of all, we will see the syntax of while loop. So there will be initialization, like I have taken a counter as I. So let's declare it also to be used the same way. Now int I equal to 1. Now we will write while. While is a keyword, and here you will mention the terminating condition. So this is the place where you are going to, keep your terminating condition. Again, it can be any logical expression, relational expression. Okay, so the value will be either true or false. Okay. And then inside these curly braces, this is the body of the loop. These are the statements that you want to repeat again and again. So suppose we want to print hello, so write hello here like this. Okay, and I am also putting a slash in so that you can see them clearly. like this. Now one thing is remaining, this is initialization, this is terminating condition, this is body of the loop, and at the end there will be updation. Okay, so how it is going to be executed? First of all, the value of I will be 1. It will check the condition. I less than equal to 10, yes, condition is true. If condition is true, it will go inside the body, okay, inside these curly braces, and then it will execute the statement. So it will print the hello in the screen, on the screen, and then there is I plus plus. I will be incremented, and now I will become 2. Again, the condition will be checked. We will not go outside the loop. We will go again, to the condition. The control will be transferred to this condition, and again this condition will be checked. So 2 is less than equal to 10. Again, the condition is true. So again, this statement will be printed. Again, the value of I will be incremented. And this will continue again and again until the condition becomes false. So when the value of I will become 11, in such situation, 11 is less than equal to 10. This condition is false. So the transfer will control, transfer will move outside the loop. Okay. Now here I just want to clear the concept of entry control loop also, because we are checking the condition, this terminating condition, we are checking the condition before entering inside the body of the loop. So this is called entry control loop. So while loop and for loop, both are entry control loop. And one more thing, how it is going to affect, it is, suppose I have put here 11. Okay, so in that situation, it is not 11 is less than equal to 10. This condition is false. So this statement is not going to be executed. Okay. Totally it is not going to be executed, not even a single time. Because it will check the condition, and condition comes out to be false. Okay. So let's first of all execute. Yes, and you can see that 10 times hello is printed. Okay, like this. So this is about the while loop, and it is entry control loop. I think this much is clear to you. If it is clear, please like the video. Okay, and if there is some doubt, then do comment, and I will try to clear your doubt. Okay, now we come to do while. Okay, after that I will tell you about the do while, and at the last we go to the for loop. Okay, so we'll see the do while loop and the condition is at the end, terminating condition. That's why it is the do while loop is the only example of the exit control loop. And why it is called exit control, you can see that this terminating condition is at the end. Okay, before exiting, while exiting you are going to check the condition, so that's why it is called exit control loop. Okay, at the exit you will decide whether to repeat or not, whether to iterate or not. In case of while loop, while entering you will decide whether to repeat or not, whether to execute or not. Okay, so what will happen, the working I will be equal to 1, do it will go inside the loop, it will print hello, then I will be 2, then the condition will be checked. If 2 is less than equal to 10, yes, the condition is true. Then we are going to repeat it again. So this condition is going to decide whether to repeat or not. Clear? Again the hello is printed, and again this I plus plus, and in this way the loop will go on and on and on until the condition becomes false. So the output will be same whether we are using while loop or do while. Understand? So it's up to you that statement you are comfortable, use that statement. Okay, so this is exit. And yes, I just want to show, if the value of I is equal to 11, then let's see what happens. You can see hello is printed once. So even if the condition is false, terminating condition is false, this block of statement, this body of the loop is going to be executed at least one, even if the condition is false. So this is the important characteristic of exit control loop. Now we'll see the for loop. For loop is nothing but all these conditions, you know, this initialization condition, updation condition, and the terminating, sorry, updation statement, initialization statement, and the terminating condition. We combine them in, you know, one line, and then it becomes for loop. Okay. So how we are going to do this? Just this is the I equal to 1. This is the initialization statement. Then I am going to write this terminating condition and then this updation. And here we have this for. And we don't need this updation statement here. So that is the for loop, and here we have to declare this counter variable. So we'll declare here. You can declare it inside for also. So you can write also like int. You can do also that. Okay. This is for loop, and the working of for loop, or we can say the sequence is, first of all, this statement is executed, I equal to 1, this which is the initialization statement, and this statement will execute only once. Okay, for the first time it will be executed, you know, very first, you know, this will be the first statement that is going to be executed inside for, and also this is executed only once. The second number is this terminating condition. We'll check whether I is less than equal to 10. So before entering inside the loop, we are checking the condition. That's why it is called entry control loop. So it becomes 1 less than equal to 10. Yes, condition is true. Then we will execute this block of statement. So hello will be printed. Then we'll go to the updation statement, and I plus plus, it will become 2. Again, we will check the condition. Condition is true. Then again, this body will be executed. Now I will become 3. Again, the condition is true. Again, this body will be executed. This process will go on repeating until the condition becomes false. Then we will come outside this for. Okay, so this is the most popular looping statement, which is for state. So I hope all these statements for, while, and do while are clear to you. If it is so, then please share my video with your friends also. And now we'll see the nested looping. Okay, and I suggest that first, you know, be an expert or be a master. Master these looping statements, you know, simple looping statements for, while, and do while, and then move towards this nested loop. Okay. But in this video, I'm going to tell you about the nested loop also. So let's see. And this is J plus plus. So here there is one for loop inside another for loop. Okay. We will write here J equal to, and here we are going to print J. Simply, I just wanted to tell you that how this nested loop works, or what is the flow of you know, statements inside a nested loop. That's just I want to take. Okay, so for that I am taking this simple example, and most of the pattern or series or like this programs are made using the nested loop. And this, so here we are going to print the value of I, here we are going to print the value of J. Alright, and here I just want to change the line. Yes. So that's all. Like we have to declare J also. Yes, you can see now that when the value of I is equal to 1, j goes from 1, j equal to 1, j equal to 2, j equal to 3. Again, when the value of I becomes 2, again j goes from 1 to 3. Again, when I becomes 3, j becomes 1, 2, and 3. So, this is the nested looping. Now, we will see the working of this nested looping. So, basically, first of all, this statement is executed and the value of I becomes 1. Second, this statement is executed, condition is checked. Condition is true, then we are going to, then this particular statement is executed and is printed as I equal to 1. Then we execute this inner loop, inner for loop, and the value of j becomes 1. Condition is checked, j is less than equal to 3. Yes, the condition is true. Now it is printed j equal to 3. Now what happens that it goes to this updation statement. It cannot go outside this j loop until this particular condition becomes false. So j becomes 2, again the condition is 2, so it is printed as j equal to 2, again j becomes 3, then again the condition is 2, so it is printed as j equal to 3. Now j becomes 4, now the condition becomes false, and then it comes outside this loop and the line is changed, and then again, you know, we cannot go outside this I loop also until this particular condition becomes false. So, first of all, we go and update the value of I. It becomes 2. 2 less than equal to 3. Again, the condition is 2. Now, this all these steps are repeated for the value of I as 2. So, again, the j becomes 1. You know, in the last iteration, j became 4. But now, again, when we will come inside this loop, again the j will be evaluated, j will be initialized, and j again will become 1, and again it is going to be executed 3 times, and it is printed as j equal to 1, 2, and 3. Again we will go to this I loop, and you know, now I hope it is clear to you. Again the value of I will be 3, and this particular outer I loop will be terminated when the value of I becomes 4, and then we will go straight outside both the loops. So this is basically the nested loop. Clear? So I hope all these you know, looping is clear to you, and if you know, you have any doubts, then please share it on the comments, and please share the programs that you are making using these loops. I will love to see them. Okay, so bye bye, keep learning, keep growing.